A lakeside view takes on a different momentum when paired with gardens at roofside perspective. Architecture and architectural plants come together on rooftop gardens that are pleasing to the eye and to the environment. Food for the family prospers beyond reach of foraging deer. It all begins with project architect Tom Tornbjerg's renovation of an existing house.
When we started with this, it was a 1980s just pink brick home builder house. It could have been on any lot in Austin. It really had no connection to the lake or the landscape beyond. So our primary focus was just to open the house up, update it a bit, and really connect back to, you know, to the beautiful setting that's here.
Tom united indoors and out with glass walls framed by a reflecting pool.
In a climate like Texas, having just a little bit of water really just provides a lot of psychological comfort. And the way that it plays with the natural light through different times of day and different conditions, I mean, the house is never the same. It's always changing because of the interplay of you know, light and water and reflection.
Garden designer Patrick Kirwin framed a lake view with perpetual structure and colors that change with the seasons.
We wanted to keep it very simple to enhance the architecture around the house and then do more of a planting mix around the edges of the property.
Even in a courtyard designed around Tom's water trough, Patrick chose low-maintenance structural plants and seasonal blooming white roses for uncluttered reverie.
The homeowner's dining room is right off of that courtyard, so you can open up the door and listen to the water as you're having dinner.
To give spatial geometry to an existing structure and provide expansive views, Tom designed roof gardens. The new roofscape is ideal for growing edibles, safe from deer and rabbits. Basils quickly head to the kitchen in summer, while lettuce takes their place in winter. Espaliered apples join artichokes and asparagus. The trellis supports young champanelle grapevines.
In integrating the roof gardens, we said, okay, well, maybe we could make this be, you know, trellis for grapevines. And we worked with Patrick in selecting a vine that's going to grow up and, you know, eventually take that wood structure over, so it's going to be more of a vegetated presence in the roofscape of the house.
It harbors more kitchen harvests in this secret room for reverie. Soil depth varies.
One section is 24 inches deep and one section is 18 inches deep. And the upper section is the deeper section, and we have fruit trees in there and asparagus and artichokes. So those plant materials need a little bit deeper soil depth for the root systems. And then the lettuce basil beds, the soils are a little bit shallower. Where the Meyer's lemon is I think 36 inches deep. So we have varying heights, which really worked out well. The architects positioned the layout of the beds and the depth of the beds so that it wasn't just a flat plane for a roof garden, that we had some definition in varying heights of the beds. I worked with George from GeoGrowers, and we came up with I guess kind of our own soil mix, and we did many different trials and watched water drain out of buckets for a long time, and finally came up with a soil mix that we think is working really well. It does have very good mineral content and has a compost component, sand, and a perlite component, and so it's very well draining, but it holds moisture.
The opposite side of the roofscape overlooks the front yard and the courtyard garden. Here, Patrick chose structural plants for this serene loft in colors that magnify its shadier placement.
Also, those species grow much slower, so there's a lot less maintenance.
He used similar xeric low-clutter plants in Tom's balcony roof garden off the bedrooms. Tom used tempered glass for an unrestrained upper story perspective to the lake. Its viewpoint connects to the third roof garden atop the boat dock. Like the roofscape, the family wanted a garden, not just a deck. Patrick softened its borders with plants that play up the lake's glimmer day or night.
We wanted to also have a soft element so that the homeowners could lay out in the summertime and possibly have a picnic. So we took the grass that we had below and brought it up here to the upper deck and kind of surrounded the hot tub with it so that it would also be a soft space for people when they get out of the hot tub to walk around. On this roof, underneath the turf, we have 6 inches of soil. In all of the planting beds, there's 3 inches of soil.
They chose black lava rock to blend in with the home's black steel and for its lightweight composition.
The gray is kind of a neutral color, so all of the greens and grays and maroons really stand out, whereas if you had a brown mulch, the plant material wouldn't shine as much as it does. The other thing that worked out really well is this doesn't break down like mulches.
Roof gardens tie into many benefits, including rainwater control and reducing the heat island effect. The immediate reward, though, is one that's top on the list.
There's beauty and there's utility and there's performance, right? The beauty is pretty obvious. It, you know, ties you in with nature.